Hi everyone, I wanted to walk you through some of my aloe before we extract some aloe gel. The first that you saw was the aloe vera we'll be working with today. What you're looking at right now is known as a hardy aloe. So these are densely packed. You can see they're a little bit darker green. They have these tiny teeth all around the edges. This one is a Christmas Carol aloe. Pretty distinctive for those red spots that line the leaves. And this one is a lace aloe. So that one's, you know, pretty decorative one. This one is a white fox aloe. This one is a tiger tooth aloe. These ones grow upward. And I wanted to mention this last one. It's an aloe chinensis. So this one can be used for burns, but this one is a not edible one. So I wouldn't eat this one, even though it can be used for some medicinal reasons like the aloe vera working with today.
Kind of an outermost piece. Get a good grip on it. Just tug it back and forth. You can pull it down. I'm usually able to snap it off. Really big piece here. You can also really just take any piece and cut it, but it's easiest just to pull from the bottom layers.
You might want to keep your gloves on for this next step. I didn't, but probably should have, because the spikes can still be painful if you hit them, which is why what I'm doing right now is cutting them off. So obviously we cut them off so we don't stab ourselves, but also because it makes it much easier to get the gel out when we do that. You can always scrape, I usually at the end, scrape out the gel from the corners as well, just so we can get everything that's in there. So just running the knife, I usually use like a paring knife, a small one for this, along the edges. It kind of feels like I'm like filleting a fish when I do it. And you'll see the goal is really, you know, just to get the center of it out. So just getting the knife, hold it up so you can see, just as close to the outside as possible, and then just running the knife, make sure it's a sharp one, so that way this is easier to do. Just running the knife along the outside edge all the way to the bottom, and then peel that off. You do want to make sure that you get all of the outside off, especially if you're planning to consume this. Rinse it off. Get all the outside pieces off, because those can make you sick. There we go. Yeah, still a little bit of the outside pieces on the bottom there. I'm not planning on eating it. I generally just use it for sunburns and burns and for dry skin, which are some of the best uses. I think I know a lot of people eat it. You know, cut up the cubes. Again, just wash it off. Make sure you get all, it's all really latex on the outside. Although people do use that too as like a laxative, I don't know that I would suggest that, but I do know that that is used for medicinal reasons also. So if you see like yellow liquid coming out of the leaves, that's the latex there. I just try to, you know, avoid that. Obviously, if it gets on my skin, that's fine, but I'm not trying to eat it. So here we go. Our big aloe chunk. You can just leave it like this, or if you want, you can cut it up into cubes. I'll just leave it like this for now. Some people put it in a blender also. Blend it up, put it in smoothies, I know it's pretty popular, or make aloe vera juice out of it. You could add it to different like lotions, add different ingredients to it. I saw something about putting honey in it and making honey and cinnamon, I think, making a face mask. Because it's good for your skin. So I'm just going to try to make sure I get the rest of this out of here. Again, if I was planning on eating it, I probably wouldn't be scraping so close to the outside of the leaves, because the latex is super bitter also. So you really don't want to, you actually don't want to be eating that, because it doesn't taste good. So I want to get the rest of this out here. So again, doing the same thing, cutting off the teeth on the ends. This piece was a little bit thinner, so I expect there won't be quite as much inside. And you can see how much of the latex is all sticky and slimy. So you do really want to be careful with the knife. Also, because your hand can slip and you don't want to stab yourself. Okay, still a decent amount, even though it was a pretty thin leaf. Get the teeth off. And again, the uses for this, there's many uses, but I just generally use it for sunburns and dry skin. And I also, to keep it, I like to have some in the either refrigerator or the freezer. You can put it in either one, and it does keep longer. So if you wanted to, you know, cut a few at a time and keep them for a couple weeks, that's usually what I do. All right. And as I mentioned before, sometimes I like to scrape the rest out there. Although I'm probably not doing it in the safest way because I'm holding the spines. But just scraping that out, because there's still a good amount in the corners, especially when you have those really fat leaves. You can get a lot out. And it is much cheaper than buying the traditional aloe vera at the store. So I think that this is really the best way to go. They also put a lot of additives in that as well. So I like to avoid that and just go for it as it is in nature. Just grab it in a plastic bag now. As I mentioned, I like to just put them, especially if you have a sunburn specifically, getting it cold out of the refrigerator is always pretty nice. All right, there we go. There's our aloe vera gel.
Subscribe to learn more with us.